In today's last-minute cheat sheet for PDE exam, let's compare two fully managed relational database solutions from Google Cloud, CloudSQL and Cloud Spanner. CloudSQL is a fully managed relational database service for MySQL, PostgreSQL, and SQL Server. It supports performance-intensive workloads with up to 60,000 IOPS. Easily scale up as your data grows, and up to 64 processor cores, and more than 400 gigabytes of RAM, up to 30 terabytes of storage, and the read replicas to handle increasing read traffic. You can review the main features of CloudSQL and which database engines support these features in this page. Also, go to the CloudSQL Features page, which describes the major features and the capabilities for which versions of DB engines. You should understand the difference between failover and read replicas in CloudSQL before the exam. Here is the architecture diagram on failover. Failover is for CloudSQL high availability. The primary instance and standby instance are located in two zones within the same region. Again, within one region. Review this page for more details on HA. Well, replication is the ability to create copies of the CloudSQL instance or from on-premise database and offload work to the copies. CloudSQL supports three types of read replicas. Review the replica use cases and a quick reference before the exam. This two architecture diagram show how to securely connect to a SQL instance. The CloudSQL proxy provides secure access to your instance without the need for authorized networks or for configuring SSL. You can use a service account to authorize access from Google Computer Engine, Google App Engine, Cloud Functions, and Cloud Run. Another option to access a CloudSQL instance by using private IP. You're using private service access. Private services access is implemented as a VPC peering connection between your VPC network and the underlying Google services VPC network where your CloudSQL instance resides. If you need to manually control over the SSL connection, you can generate and periodically rotate the certificates yourself. Otherwise, you can use an unencrypted connection by authorizing a special IP address to connect to your SQL server over its external IP address. CloudSQL uses Google Managed Data Encryption Keys, DEK, and Key Encryption Keys, KEK, to encrypt CloudSQL. But you can also provide a custom managed encryption key, CMEK, to do data at rest encryption. I didn't have any questions on CloudSQL IAM in my exam. The CloudSQL IAM is on project and CloudSQL instance level. Provide two access control links for your reference. In CloudSQL best practices, pay attention to the following best practices. For read-heavy workloads and read replicas to offload traffic from the primary instance, shard your instances where possible. Speed up imports by using the appropriate MySQL dump command when you export. Review the details of the best practice if you have time. In our next two videos, I will go through the cheat sheet of Cloud Spanner and the Relational Database Service Decision Tree. Thanks for watching, and as always, subscribe to my channel for more great cloud computing learning tips. Thank you.